bullet time and a little bit of money. Yeah. But the return on something like a bus station is huge.
Pianist.
Okay.
Trying to be. I haven't played in a long time. I just restarted.
Keep it up.
Working on Goldberg.
Oh. Thank you to Pastor Tim for having me, and also to Diane, and thank you all for being here today. You could be somewhere else on a Sunday afternoon or having a nice siesta somewhere. And also thank you to those downstairs who I can't see. But nice to have you all here, and it's nice to have you right here intimately up here, because I'm so used to playing a city block away from the altar and you know, the congregation is downstairs and they're so far away. So it's nice to see you all here face to face. And I hope you enjoy it today. The first piece is Pièce d'Orgue of J.S. Bach, and this is in three parts. The first part is all in the hands, Manualiter, and it's kind of simulates a fast-moving violin in 16th notes, rapid notes. The second middle part is kind of in that French dissonance and resolution style with the cantus firmus kind of in the pedal, and wonderful resolutions and trills and whatnot. And then the third part is that fast Italian style again, like a violin, very fast notes in the hands, and then this pedal point, D, that repeats over and over and over again until it resolves to G. Thank you. is, this next piece is the loosely translated. It's a hymn to the Virgin Mary about her Immaculate Conception. And so this is a Spanish composer, Araujo, and the it's a variation, it's a theme of variations. So you'll get to hear the initial theme, and then I'll make it a little bit more colorful each time by adding maybe a 2 foot or a 1 1/3 foot stop on the organ. But this is to the Blessed Virgin Mary. Her feast day for this Immaculate Conception is December the 8th, but every denomination honors Mary, and so I thought it would be nice to include her, especially during this month of Women's Month, March. Domenico Zippoli, and he studied to become a Jesuit priest but didn't quite make it to holy orders. He died before that time. He was very young. But he was born in Italy, died in Argentina. And these three pieces are a part of a set of organ pieces that he put together in two books. And so these are mostly manual liturgy. The second movement, the pastoral, has a drone pedal that just holds in C and G.
Thank you.
you notice that on these Italian pieces, I would only hold one pedal at a time. That's because the organs from this time period in Italy had very short, stubby pedals. They didn't have the pedals like we have here that are long, and there are about 30 or so of them, but they were short, and many times you could just pull down what was being done in the hands, and almost sometimes they didn't have the registers that you could pull out separately for the pedals, and so that's why it's like a pedal point for each of these pieces. The next piece is by Albero, and this is actually a harpsichord piece, but it works very well on the organ. He was a harpsichordist, and he was also the first organist at the Royal Chapel in Madrid.
Thank you.
next set of three pieces is very quick. They're short. Sister Mary David Callahan was a Benedictine monk, and she wrote a lot of works, orchestral works, choral works, instrumental works, pieces for organ. But these are very short, a minute or less each, and they are based on Gregorian chants. Christus Vincit, which the beginning text of that translates loosely, Christ conquers, Christ reigns, Christ commands. And then the Ave Verum, of course, is a Eucharistic hymn that can be sung during communion. The Salve Mater is again to the Blessed Virgin Mary, and Hail Mother of Mercy, Mother of God, of Hope, of Grace, and Mother full of Holy Gladness. And this is Sister Mary David Callahan, an American Benedictine nun.
Thank you.
set of pieces is by Eugenio Maria Faggiani, who is an Italian organist, composer, recording artist, improviser. He just gave a couple of concerts here in New York last month. And he's at the organist at the Cathedral in La Verna, Italy, where it's a huge Franciscan shrine. But he wrote several compositions in Gregorian Stant Child, he continues to do so. But these two are the Pange Lingua, which is a Eucharistic hymn, typically heard during benediction, maybe communion, but especially on Holy Thursday, when many churches have this procession inside the church and take the host into a repository. And that's what we do at St. Patrick's on Holy Thursday with this hymn. And then the Ubi Caritas follows that, and that's a hymn of love. Where there is love, there is God.
Thank you.
next piece is also based on Gregorian chant. This is Attende Domine, which is for the penitential season of Lent, which means you're calling on the Lord, hear us, O Lord, and forgive our sins, have mercy on us. And so this is by Jeanne de Monsieur, who was a French woman composer who was known for her fabulous technique and wrote all this difficult music, but this happens to be one of her easier things from her set of 12 Gregorian chant settings. Next piece is Adoration by Florence Price, and she was born in Little Rock, Arkansas, and was very prolific with her writing. She wrote orchestra symphonies and pieces for choir, pieces for organ, pieces for piano, and another woman for this month of Women's Month.
Thank you.
set of three pieces comes from a set of 24 piano pieces for children, but it is by a Ukrainian composer, and because of everything going on, I wanted to include something that was Ukrainian on this program, and this was simple enough to learn in the last few weeks. Viktor Lysenko was born in St. Petersburg, but then died in Ukraine, and so it's the folk song, a melody, and a pastoral. And then I'll finish the program by playing another woman composer, Fanny Mendelssohn. You'll know her as Felix Mendelssohn's sister. And thank you all for being here today, and it's great to have you here close up where I can see you, and I don't have to shout all the way down there. And hello to those down there as well. But thank you to Pastor Tim and to Diane for having me here today. And hope you have a beautiful rest of the Lent season.
Thank you.